Hey, I'm Austin Clark. This is where I'm living at, beside the Hilltop Diner, 421. We took a lot of pictures of the appliances in the house and, of course, the exterior of the home. The power bill in the wintertime is $130 approximately, and then summertime is $75, $80. We went through and did all of the tests. I do have a small wind unit that is super old. That's the only coolant in the house. It's really just a fan, but we did calculate its performance and how much it costs per month.
Yeah, so I'm Graham Avery. So you actually right here, these are some numbers that we got from each of the appliances that are currently in use at the house. The AC window unit was by far the most accurate one because they actually had numbers on the unit itself. So we were able to get a cost for it. The washer and dishwasher and dryer, they had some numbers, but it was only just like the wattage. So we were able to get somewhat some numbers out of them. The refrigerator, I couldn't find numbers on her, and I don't think any of us could, so we weren't able to get very accurate, but I found a model similar to the one that was there, as a similar Whirlpool model. The oven, I found a generalized number from another similar model. The hours in use, that was just kind of an approximation. So we, like the washer and dryer, we did one load a week. So that's only 8 hours a month, and this is a monthly base graph. So, I mean, that's how we got all that data, and just go from there. The improvement opportunities, the biggest thing was the AC, which is an old window unit. It didn't perform terrible. I mean, honestly, all of the appliances could be upgraded because they're all older style, but, you know, considering the house is just a single wide, and the power bill is only like $75, $130, and somewhere in that range. It's hard to justify spending several hundred dollars, several even thousand on new appliances. First test we did was the air leakage test. This one, as you can see in the picture, we had it set up. We actually tested it in two different ways. The first one was we just did a normal open system, and we just closed off the windows with their natural sealing capability. We didn't put any towels or anything in there. We didn't try to seal up any cracks in the house. And so we ran our test, and we estimated the volume of the house was 3,200 feet squared. The first test ended up being a ACH at 50 and 32.81. Test two, we did a similar setup, but we tried to kind of benefit the housing enclosure by putting towels around the AC unit, putting towels around the cracks in the doors, just trying to get it as tight as possible. We ran it again. We ended up getting a little slightly better number. It was ACH at 50, which is would be 30.94. Keep going down. These numbers are pretty good. Here's a graph, to kind of a visual graph to see exactly where the house stands. So we're right in here, which this number, if you can't read it, is 0.35, 0.41. You know, as you get farther this way, it's very leaky. As you get farther this way, it's, you know, more tight. And we were actually on the better end of the spectrum, which is probably because it's a single wide and it's just got remodeled, so it's actually pretty quality inside the house. The exterior may look a little beat up, but the interior and like windows and door jams are all pretty tight. That's really good. All
right, my name is Patrick Clark. So we went through and we looked at some of the different building enclosures, like the exterior walls, the windows, things like that. As Graham was talking, some of these, some of the outer exterior views, you would think that it would maybe have lots of thermal or air leakage going on, but whenever we actually went through with our thermal camera, we really found that most of the places that it was, the only real places that it was leaking was more from like this air conditioning unit, and then also from like this door right here, this main front door. There could have been some some better sealing that can be done on that. But we really didn't find that too much going on with the leakage. This picture, I know it's hard to see right here, but this is actually a picture of the ceiling or the roof system. We were noticing that there was some heat gain coming through the thermal bridging on the rafters. But other than that, it's a pretty tight house. The windows look like they are newer and they've been sealed in pretty good. There's no real drafts coming from any of the vents, things like that. So the next things that we actually went through and did is we did the duct blaster test. We went ahead and we went through and we taped up all the vents. We made sure that, here's Austin right here, taping up some vents. And then this vent obviously is also taped. We went ahead and we took the tubing for the fan itself, taped it up to the return so that we could make sure that we got a good seal on it so that when we ran our test, we would get the best numbers. We found the information, if you'll scroll back up just a here. We found that we had approximately 40 feet of ductwork in there. And then when we set the calibration up and worked it all out, we had a CFM of 730. When that was all averaged out, we found out that it was about 18.25 cubic feet per minute per foot that was actually being lost. We couldn't get up underneath the house itself to look at any of the ductwork or the crawl space or anything like that. So there may have been some leakage in the duct themselves, but not that we could physically get down there and see. The leakage that we did find, you know, was mainly from that window unit. That's about it. Alright, scroll back down.
Okay, our last test that we did was the ventilation fan test, and this was the one where you basically just put the box over a vent, like in the bathroom, which is where we're going in the bathroom in here. And it turned out, so you can see here, it's pretty simple. There's the top of the vent where it comes out of the house, and here's us in the bathroom performing the test. This took a team effort from all of us. You know, we had somebody holding it up and running the numbers, and I was videotaping. So the results of this one right here were not as good as we would have hoped for. It was only about a 30 CFM is what we got from the results. And this is not good because the average is 70 CFM for a newer model bathroom fan. So that could definitely get upgraded, you know. It's not that big of a deal, but we did notice, you know, it was a little stuffy in the bathroom. That's something that could be fixed if it had a better fan, you know, pulling the air out, you know, and that's basically that test. So our conclusion and analysis, like I said, I don't need to go into detail and read every bit of this, but basically the house is pretty solid, and on the exterior it doesn't look like it would be a very solid house, but because of its simplicity, because it is a single wide, and it just got remodeled on the inside with new drywall, insulation, windows, it's a solid little house. It's really simple in the duct work. There's a heating unit, and then the duct goes just from the heating unit under the house, and it breaks off four different times to give you each of the vents. So it's real simple. The duct work itself was pretty solid. Yeah, overall it was a pretty solid little house. At the end of this, we got a basic floor plan of the house. These are our sources. We've got a bunch. These two are links to the videos of us performing the test. They didn't work, so I'm going to attach them to the end of this video. So I'll just have them pop on right at the end of this video. And that's basically it.
All right, so we are just trying to get to 50. Oh, yeah, now. All right, so turn down just a little bit. Okay. All right, right. Just a little bit here. See right there, it's saying low, 17, 7, 7, 18. It's having a hard time doing that.
Pop the crank it up a little high.
Yeah, but it's going to be way over 50 pascals, so you're going to try putting
put another one in, like another.
So that's still too low to read. So we're gonna turn that off. We're gonna put in ring one. And there's no clips on here. So Austin, do you want to do it? I'll just hold it.
Just 35. We got a long ways to go.
Actually, hang on, because this is what that dude did as well. Put it off. Since we put one in, we have to hit configure, and that's A1. So there we go. Now let's try it again. Still on one.
$730
will be our number.
$730. Yeah. All right. Cool. You can go ahead.